You probably think that it's very hard to make a stable income with photography, but this is because you keep thinking in old ways to do it. So nowadays, to be able to have an stable income, you're gonna have to adapt to modern life. And I'm gonna explain later in the video what I mean with this. So today I'm gonna show you how you can do to be able to get clients every month rather than having one once in a blue moon and then don't have more work, because we all struggled with that at the beginning. So follow along, and I think this video is gonna be quite useful if you wanna make money with your camera. I'm gonna put you in perspective. So my main niche, if you follow my channel, you know that is portrait photography. So for example, my main clients are music artists, you know guys that I love to shoot with talents, and models, because I work in the fashion industry as well. But guys, these kind of clients, they come back to you once and that's it. Maybe they come the year after, or maybe, for example, with artists, they come to me twice per year, three times per year to renew their press shots, because obviously they use them a lot and then they need more. Okay, this is not sustainable, because obviously three times per year is not gonna be enough for you to eat and make a living with your camera. This is stressful because you have to be all the time looking for new clients and it's very hard to maintain. So the solution is to adapt to modern life. And you have to do this because nowadays it's not like before anymore. Photographers used to focus in just one niche and be super good at it or keep improving themselves and try to make a business shooting just that thing. In my opinion, this is super dangerous because, for example, I shoot many niches, many categories. I love photography and you will see me always putting more videos in this channel about other kind of photography because I love it and I love teaching as well. And this is super good because during the lockdown, I mentioned that time ago, I couldn't shoot with people. What happens if you're a portrait photographer and you cannot shoot with people and you have no clue about other kind of photography? How are you gonna eat if you're a freelancer and you just earn your money with your camera? You're not gonna be able to make even £1, $1, I don't know, whatever the currency. And this is super dangerous. For me during the lockdown, I was doing product photography and this saved me. But I do many other things as well, and then I upload in stock photography. So having versatility and be able to shoot landscape, wildlife, action shots in sports, for example, portrait photography, product photography from home is very good to earn money as well. Guys, you need to be versatile. I would say focus in your niche 75%, do that work, get better at it, focus on that to make a business, but be flexible the other 25%. Even more, I would say, because so many times I was doing other kind of photography and no portrait at all, which is very annoying because I love portrait, but you need to make a living with your camera. Versatility is key. This is my opinion by my own experience. I think this is very good. And also, you have to focus on social media. If you are a photographer, don't focus on taking pictures for clients and that's it. Focus on social media. Why? Because after what is going on, everyone realizes the importance of being online. So everyone needs Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, many social media networks, but Instagram is the main one for you. Not that you need to be on Instagram, that as well, obviously, even though it's a bit annoying nowadays because it's very hard to grow, but brands need Instagram because it's how they get discovered by other clients. So offer content creation services. I love doing this because what happened is you create a fee, like a loyalty fee for the client, and you tell them, okay, if it's a one-off photo shoot, I charge you this. But you come in a monthly basis, I create 30 posts, for example, for one post per day, I create 30 posts for you, photography posts, and you don't have to worry about sharing professional content anymore, and I charge you this fee, which is cheaper. So for loyalty, if the client comes back to you every month, you charge a fixed fee, and you create the content for them. This is what I do to keep stable, because as I told you, I have many clients like artists, and it's what I love the most, but if I don't have, I don't know, any artists that month, I have clients that come to me every month because I create content for them and they need the content every month. So this is a very good trick for you. And the other trick, well, not trick, this is something you have to do. If you're a photographer, you have to learn video. I'm sorry to say this. I learned video because during the first lockdown, I started my YouTube channel. I wanted to learn video, I wanted to teach photography, and because of that, now I offer video services. And you get paid more with video, so it's another source of income you can get. And this is key as well for social media. Because I don't know if you know, but I tell you, Video has more reach nowadays in social media. So user Reels, no IGTV anymore because they remove it, but videos and Reels is key on Instagram to grow. So brands would hire someone who can do photography and video. If you know just photography and you cannot deliver video or Reels or things like that, they're gonna look for other photographer. I think video is key. And if you didn't yet, I'm gonna put my free email template to approach brands down below. So many of you already took it and you guys are using it. So it's free. You have to adapt it in your own words and to the brand. Don't send the same email to everyone because it's a mistake. But it's gonna give you an idea of how you have to approach professionally and friendly to a brand. So grab it down below. And the next point I wanna talk about is my favorite one, which is going online. This is what I've done, what I'm doing, because obviously I'm not full-time online. My main source of income is client work still. But I started to make a tiny income online and I started last year my YouTube channel. And I know maybe YouTube is not for you. Trust me, it wasn't for me. I thought about YouTube like years ago and it's like, no way. I can do my self-portraits and everything, but I cannot be behind the camera talking. Even this video did so many mistakes already because I'm not good talking at camera and less with my English. So I struggle, but I do it and then it becomes easier. So even if it's not for you, maybe think about it. Think about it because I think it's gonna be worth it. And if it's not YouTube, go on TikTok, Instagram. Try to be online. Because you are not online nowadays, you don't exist. And people cannot find you, clients cannot find you, and this is super important. With what is going on, you have to be online. Because if there is more lockdowns, you're not gonna be able to make money. I don't know if you know about Metaverse. Metaverse is the new name for Facebook, Instagram, blah, 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 all these companies, you know already. And they already announced the launch of VR in less than 10 years. This means that you're gonna put your glasses at home and you're gonna be able to work remotely with an avatar, with a hologram. This is crazy, but it's happening. We will believe like it's never gonna happen in our age, but it's happening already because they announced it. So what I mean with this, if you are not already online and then in 10 years this comes, you're not gonna exist. Even for creators, they said, like for example, I can invite you guys to my studio. So you will be able to put some VR glasses and come to my studio with your avatar and I can teach you guys photography. It's insane, I think it's great, but this is where I'm going with that. You have to be online, even if you don't like it, because you can make money from it. Make a blog. If you don't wanna do video, YouTube, TikTok, you should, but if you can't because it's not for you, make a blog online that you can monetize. And for sure have a website. I always push you with this for your portfolio, but you can do a blog and you can monetize it. I do have a video about this as well. I said it, I think at the beginning of all this madness. I'm gonna link it down below about how to make money with photography without clients. So go check it out. But these are the main things, like do content creation, monthly content creation for brands so they keep coming back to you. Be versatile with your photography instead of shooting just one niche because you're gonna have more money coming up if you shoot more things. And be online, not just for your portfolio, but also to be discoverable with clients and to be there whenever this kind of metaverse crazy thing is gonna happen. So I really hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you didn't yet. Like the video, please, because it helps me a lot. And I will see you very soon. Big love.